Hello and welcome to part 2 of the lip sync demonstration. In part 1, we already explained what was the construction mode, which is really important for all of the operators that we're going to be connecting onto the geometry. In this case here, we're going to be doing some shapes for our little character for the lip sync, so we might as well switch our mode. We're presently in modeling, so we're going to switch now to shape modeling. There you go. The second step is that we're going to go under the shape deformation, and we're just going to make sure that we've got two modes that are toggled on. First of all, we want to work with the mix weight mode. This is really important because in subsequent demonstration, we're going to be showing to you new tools inside the dope sheet and also the animation editor that works very well with this mode here. The other one also is apply selected shape keys. As soon as we've got, you know, like some shapes that are created, we want them to be applied into the mixer automatically for us. So once we've got this done, what we can do is that we can switch to the Fort Mimo cam, where we've got clones of the actual head of Dr. Beck Bunsen. We already created our voiles on one side and then the consonant on the other one. So we're ready to go and pick these guys so that they're going to become the shapes that will be used for doing the lip sync. Let's select the good old doctor. Let's go under Animate, Deform Shape, Select Shape Key. We're going to go in a picking session, and XSI is asking us, okay, which head do you want to use for doing the lip sync of your character? Well, I want to use these fives. So I'm just going to stop there for now because I want to show you what's going to happen. XSI has picked up those five heads, and what it did is that it created for us a compound. You can see that the compounds are always darker in color than the original shape. In this case here, it's a darker blue. If I double click on it, we're now inside the compound, and you're going to see that the shapes have been applied, first of all, to the full length of the timeline, from frame 0 or frame 1, all the way to 200. You're going to see that we've got all five of them, so it represents the A, U, O, E, and I. Those are the five that we picked up there. So why don't we keep on going? So let's go back up like this, and we're going to say, reselect the doctor, shape, select shape key, and pick up the consonant now. Alright, I'm not a singer, I know that, so I'm gonna stop singing right now. Double click on the compound and you're gonna see now that all of the other heads, which are the consonants, have been added in there. Another thing also that you're gonna notice is that on the right side here, those are the weight sliders. The weight sliders are really important when we're working in this mode because they will determine which shape is actually gonna be driving the good old doctor. In this case here, you're gonna notice that all of the weights have been set to 0 except the very last one. The last one has been set to 1, so this one is actually driving our character right now. And you're gonna see also that there's animation keys that have been set on those parameters. So why don't we do this? Let's get close, you know, like to our little doctor, and there's also another tool that is done automatically for you. If we select our character and we go under selection, there's a custom parameter set that has been set, which is called the shape weight. When you're going to open this up, it's going to give you a page with all of these sliders. All of these sliders are connected directly to all of the sliders for the weighting inside the compound. So what we are saying here is that if you go back up, you've got the ability of working with a very user-friendly property page instead of always going, you know, like inside the compound. So why don't we do this? You're going to notice that as I move those sliders, that I'm affecting the head of my character. First of all, there's a mix that is being done from the previous expression that we're done. I've got the mad and the happy, so maybe I could mute them. So you're going to see now that the only thing that is being applied onto my character is the compound. Another thing also that you might have noticed is that the names inside the property page are extremely long. Well, they refer to the parameter that we've got inside the compound, like the letter A, and then it says shape, key, mix, weight, blah, 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 blah. So what we can do is that we can actually go and change those quite easily. If we want, all we need to do is mark the parameter by clicking on it. Then we go under Animate again, Create Parameter, and we can edit the parameter definition. If I click on this, I'm going to say, okay, well, instead of being called, you know, like this super long name, I'm going to keep it, you know, like named A. As soon as I'm going to say okay, you can see that now it has been readjusted. Instead of going through all of this, what I'm going to do is just open my little script editor, and I'm going to go and get a little script that I've already created, which is going to help me out, go a little bit faster for the presentation. Those are commands that were echoed inside XSI. I just picked them up, brought them down here, changed the letters, and when I'm going to run this command, boink, so there you go. You can see that everything was readjusted. I can make it a little bit smaller like this. The next step is that maybe I want to remove all of the animation that I already have on those parameters. It's really easy to do. All you need to do is go on the big key icon that you've got in the property page, right mouse click, and you go remove animation. So we're going to have a fresh slate to start with. You're going to notice that, of course, as we're changing these sliders, that we're going for our E letter, we're going for the U, we're going for the A, all of them are contained inside those sliders. So what we're going to do is stop here for part two, and please join me in part three as we're going to be going through some audio tools.